So, how are you? Actually, in this video, I want to talk about how I finally came to Turkey and start to study here. So, I've been receiving a lot of messages in Instagram, Facebook, and those kind of social medias. Everybody was asking the same question: how? And today, I want to talk about the how. I've been in love with Turkey for years now, and at a time when I was in the second year of high school, I decided that country I want to keep living there. Okay, I don't know if I'm gonna stay after studying or not. I started searching for universities. I saw like a lot of lot. But the thing is that it's not the same way to go into a public universities, and it's not the same way to go into a private university. So, especially for Tunisians, if you guys want to study here in Turkey in a public school, that would be a little bit difficult because they have a kind of test exam called YOS. It's for foreigners that want to study here in public universities. This test actually has 70 questions, 35 math, and 35 IQ questions. The IQ questions, well, they're easy and you can do it, but the math, it's really, really hard. In that short time, 70 questions would be hard to accomplish. I got 41 out of 80, which is like the average, and it doesn't get you anywhere. So I was like, okay, no public schools. We have to search for a university, a good one, that may give me a scholarship. Because if you want a good university and private, it would be really expensive. So I had like Bahçeşehir University, Sabancı University, Koç, and Özyeğin. I had those four choices, and I was like, okay, which one? Sabancı was like so expensive. Well, every university is expensive here, but then I was like, okay, let me see Koç. Then, because they give us our baccalaureate diploma very late in Tunisia, you will be late for Koç application. So, Koç was out of my list. So, was Sabancı, Özyeğin, and then Bahçeşehir University. Bahçeşehir, they don't give scholarship for the first year. So, I was like, okay, so Bahçeşehir is out of my list too. Sabancı and Özyeğin. Okay, I got into the internet. I was like searching for people, how they think about it. Okay, Sabancı was good. But I think, I don't remember very well, but I think it's more expensive than Özyeğin. Then, the thing is about Özyeğin, they always reply on time, and even you can email them today and they answer today. So it was like super cool. And I started emailing them. They told me about the papers that I had to bring, actually to send by email, like motivation letter recommendation and your baccalaureate diploma, your scores, and the translation in Turkish language, and the IELTS or TOEFL. Okay, they don't accept IELTS anymore, so don't try to do it. But they accept TOEFL. So, and you have to get, I think, more than 80 and at least 20 per section. Or if you don't get one of these, you can pass the TRACE exam in Özyeğin University. So, about living here, is it cool? Is it not? How is it? Okay, I didn't want to stay at the dorms because I want to spend the summer in Turkey. So if I want to spend the summer in Turkey, dorms aren't very cool because they don't let students stay during the summer. So I started searching for an apartment. The first one was a disaster, so I had to move to another one. And actually, it's very far from my university. It's like 2 hours if there's traffic, 1 hour if there is no traffic. But I live in Kadıköy. Kadıköy is a very cool city for like students and for fun, and okay, I study, but fun too is an obligation in life. So, the thing is, rent is really expensive if you're living in Tunisia. Like, compared to our average rent, it is expensive. Food is expensive too compared to our country. But if you live like in a European country and want to go to Turkey, well, Turkey is really like not cheap but not expensive like a normal country. Okay, what else? Book of university are like kind of expensive. Actually, they are expensive. But the thing is that universities are really cool. You have foreigner professors like super cool stuff. We have this LMS thing that you submit your homework into, and we don't have those things in Tunisia. This is why I'm telling you guys about it. Like, everything is on the website of the university. You don't have sometimes to buy books because there's everything online, and you just bring your computer to school and start studying. Like, you don't even need notebooks or books. So that's the cool thing about it. And people are asking the same questions. Do you get friends easily? Is it really hard to get foreigner friends or Turkish friends? How is it? Well, the thing is, Turkish people are so sociable. Getting Turkish friends is easy. Okay, internationals are easy too, but it's like a little bit difficult to find internationals in the place you're living in. For example, the international people that I know, like from Germany, China, and a lot of other countries, they live next to the university. So, like, it's too far. But during the weekdays, I get to meet them, talk, go out for drinks or something like that. So that's the cool thing about it. I hope that I answered all the questions. If there is anything you want to ask more, just comment on the link on the video below. Ask me anything you like it. If there is a lot of questions, I'll do a video about questions and answers. And if you want to come here, this country is just marvelous. It's just magnificent. Really, 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 I'm loving it right now. Okay, you have to study hard. And getting a scholarship here isn't that easy. I mean, for the friends that know me, I had 15 out of 20 in my bachelor degree. Okay, and that only gave me 25% scholarship, which is nothing. Like, hard workers here get 50. The really smart and hardworking people get 75. The genius one get 100 out of 100. So, like, you have to study all the time. Okay, you have the weekend sometimes to go out, but most of the time you have to study. Like, I sometimes stay till 9 p.m. in the library, and I mean, you have to sacrifice some things. It's not just for fun, but I mean, when you get out of your house and see like the streets, those modern and historic stuff in the same country mixed together, that is like, you'd be like, wow, I want to stay here forever. So, like I said, I hope I answered all your questions. If there is anything missing, just comment below and I'll be waiting for you guys. Bye bye.